In Final Cut Pro 11, you finally have the ability to generate subtitles and captions from the audio in your video. So I wanted to show you how you can do that and how you can export those captions in a discrete file that you can use to upload to YouTube so that you have accurate closed captions for your videos. I don't know how important that is anymore. I know that YouTube auto-generates captions these days, but for me, I know that if people are watching my videos using closed caption for whatever reason, I want to make sure that they're accurate, especially for the kinds of videos that I make with maybe technical terms and jargon and like product names, company names, etc. I want those to be accurate as well. So that's one reason to do it. So with all that out of the way, let me show you how you can generate these in Final Cut Pro 11. To generate the captions, all you need to do is highlight all of the clips that contain the audio that you want to generate captions from. You could probably Command A to select everything in your timeline, but if you had any audio that has voiceover in it or some kind of voice, then it's going to obviously look at that as well. So if you want to make sure that you're only highlighting the actual audio, like your voiceover audio, then you would want to be more selective about what you actually select. So having done that, I'm just going to right click on any of those highlighted clips. Down here at the bottom, you have the transcribe to captions option. You could also do the control command C shortcut. So clicking on that, the first time you do this after updating to Final Cut 11, it's going to have a pop-up that says downloading language model. So you do that and then you shouldn't have to do that again. Since I've already done it, I didn't get that pop-up, but that's what you should see. So after that, it will just take however long it needs to take to transcribe all the audio. And now using another new feature in Final Cut Pro, we're going to hit Shift, Option, and Z, and that is going to show everything on our timeline, all the layers of our timeline. So up here at the top, we now have this caption layer. You can click on any of these, make this a little bigger, and over here in your inspector, it shows you the text, and you've got some options for formatting. You can bold, italicize, and underline the text in that one that you have highlighted. Keep that in mind. That's only applying to the one that you have currently selected. You can change the color. Works just like a normal text editor. You can move it to the top or the bottom. And as of now, that's the only options you have. You don't have the option to change the font, really anything else, unfortunately. You can make bulk adjustments. So if you just click up here on one of them, you can hit Command A, and it's only going to highlight the captions, which is nice, instead of everything in your timeline. You could also just click and drag to highlight all of them as well. So now that I have them all highlighted, I can make bulk adjustments to their color. So let's just say I want to make it orange, and I want to make them all bold and italicized. So now you can see as I scrub through this that they all have those settings applied. Now I've only used this a few times, so I can't really speak to its accuracy. It seems pretty accurate just when it comes to regular words, but it doesn't seem super keen on, you know, product names, which, I don't know, isn't surprising, I suppose. Like, this video is about this. These docs here, Ivanki, whatever they're called, it's spelling them Ivani. And it's saying, you know, Fusion Doc DOC as opposed to DOCK. And then it's randomly capitalizing the word Max. So it's pretty random. So if you want to make it accurate formatting and any sort of technical words, you're probably going to need to come up here and make those adjustments, manually typing them in. Another cool thing you can do is come over to your index, and under roles, you can see now you've got roles for the captions. So if you uncheck it, the captions will go away and they'll no longer appear over the top of your video. You can also just not show the captions on the timeline, the role itself, but they'll still be in the video. And then you also have this option over here for the captions individually. And here you just get a big list view of all the captions, and you can come through here and highlight them. And you can see how my playhead is going across the timeline, highlighting all of these captions. So that's cool. So what you can also do here is double click and a little pop-up will appear, and this allows you to make edits directly on in this little box, which would be super handy to come through. So let's do a little cleanup, Fusion Doc Pro. To me, it's important to have all of these things correct for the people that want to watch with captions. I want them to have a good experience, but of course, you can take as much or as little time as you want. This time I called it a max dot. I guess my, ooh, not a max cock. We don't want that. Or maybe we do want that. The day after this has been released, the auto caption feature only works in English. You can generate captions in multiple languages, but as far as I can understand, you basically have to do things manually. In order to, presumably, add captions in other languages, I'm going to click on one of the captions, and I'm going to hit Command-A, and then right-click, duplicate captions to new language. You have all these different options. I'm going to choose Arabic, and then you get a stack of captions, but you can see that they are not in Arabic, unfortunately. So what you supposedly have to do is double-click on... Okay, here we go. Oh god, it's so confusing. But what you would essentially have to do is choose the Arabic layer and then manually type in the caption in Arabic. Now that we have that done, we are going to export this video. So I'm going to come up into my little library, my media thing here, make sure I'm selected on the right project, right-click and share project, and I'm just going to choose the default export. And coming over to settings, everything should be pretty standard, no real changes here, but if you come over to roles, now you've got some additional options to deal with your captions. On the video track here, this captions button will bring up some options to burn in the captions to your video. However many languages you created, you can make a selection of which one. Obviously you would want to do this one at a time for different versions of the video. So this is going to burn in the captions over the top of our video. So there's one option. And then if you want to generate closed captions for your YouTube upload, you also want to come down to this captions option and check this box, export each ITT language as a separate file. I'm getting a warning because I think I made a little mistake here, but I'm not really going to worry about that right now. That was when I was trying to make an Arabic caption. And that should be good to go. Choose a spot to save that. So I've uploaded my video to YouTube, and you can see how the subtitle layer has been burned into the video. In order to add the closed captions, in your YouTube studio, under the subtitles option, click the upload file, and we're going to use with timing, hit continue, and you're going to navigate to wherever you exported your video from Final Cut Pro. And remember that you clicked to export the ITT caption file as well. So those should be there in your Finder. I think this is the right one. That ITT file will include the timestamps. So all the timing should match what is burned into the video as well. You can make changes directly on in these boxes here in YouTube. So if you didn't do that in Final Cut, you can do one last pass here and make any spelling or grammar punctuation type changes that you want to make. And then once you're done, obviously you're going to hit done. Going to come back to our video on YouTube. Click the closed caption. And there you go. So hopefully that made sense. You were able to follow along. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. And I know that I glossed over the option to create subtitles or captions in different languages, because I don't really have the ability to type in different languages on my keyboard. I don't really know how to do that. But hopefully Apple will add in more languages that you can auto-generate captions in the future. I don't really know if there's a timetable for that, but hopefully you got something out of that video, and I appreciate you watching, and maybe I'll see you in another one.